closer to Bridgetown. Friends, liberals, and fellow Nova Scotians, I am so humbled and honored that Nova Scotians have put their trust in me and our Liberal team. The people of Nova Scotia have agreed with our plan to put Nova Scotia first. And it is with a deep sense of responsibility and purpose that I will make certain that our plan is delivered and that our commitments are kept. Let me begin by congratulating Daryl and Jamie and all of the candidates who worked tirelessly during this campaign, who brought their ideas to Nova Scotia. I also want to extend my deepest appreciation on behalf of all of you and all Nova Scotians to their families. Only one name gets put on a ballot, but the entire family gets drafted into service. To all Nova Scotians who volunteer for various political parties in this campaign, I thank you. I urge you to remain engaged in the democratic process. Your ideas and your passion are essential ingredients to building an even stronger Nova Scotia. One of the best aspects of a campaign is meeting Nova Scotians across this great province. Over the past months and years, I've had the good fortune with speaking to many of you. Nova Scotians who take great pride in our beautiful province, but who also have concerns about our future. You have told me about your hopes and your dreams for a Nova Scotia where your children and grandchildren can prosper. I share that dream. I believe in a Nova Scotia where families and communities not only survive, but thrive and prosper. Our Nova Scotia is a province where families and communities come first, a province where affordable housing units are available for everyone who needs one. Our Nova Scotia is a province where victims of sexual and domestic assaults have access to the services they need, and a province that works to end violence against women and children. Our Nova Scotia is a province where health and welfare of our children is paramount. A province that, regardless of the differences of adults, parents meet the financial obligations they have to their children. Our Nova Scotia is a province where a strong education system is a priority. A province where our school system allows children not to just to meet but to exceed the challenges of an ever rapidly growing world. Education is the greatest gift we can give to one another. It is the great equalizer in this country. Our Nova Scotia is a province where our economy prospers from each and every corner of this province, where the emphasis is placed on the true engine of prosperity, the small business owners who create the jobs in both urban and rural Nova Scotia. Our Nova Scotia is a province where the healthcare system focuses on one fundamental truth: the needs of the patient must always come first. Our Nova Scotia is a province where government puts the needs of its people first. A province where every decision is led by the advice, needs, and interests of families and communities across Nova Scotia. Tonight, you have entrusted our team with the great task of making this vision a reality. My commitment to you is that we will work tirelessly to ensure that we give you honest, hard-working government that you deserve. Yeah. I ask that you continue to share your ideas, your concerns, and your vision, because I truly believe that it will only work when we come together and work together will we be able to accomplish the great vision for this province. To my Liberal team, thank you for your commitment to our plan, to your dedication to getting our message out to the people of this great province. And I am so honored and humbled to have traveled this road with you. And I look forward to working with you to ensure that we can build a better future for this province. My own family, Andrea, Colleen, and Jeffrey, this has been a long 10 years. That's correct, 14. We are humbled by the support that has been shown to us by all of you. The kindness and generosity that you've shown Andrea and Colleen and Jeffrey as we've traveled this province and this constituency. Today has been a day of great reflection. Lots of people to think about. Some who are not here with us tonight. Think about my grandparents, Manuel and Sarah, Daniel and Maud, my own parents, Bert and Teresa. Yeah. I know how grateful my mother was to this community, this county, when we as a family faced the challenges that many families face, and the warmth and generosity that all of you showed her as she was raising her children. She had a few of them. But it's what makes a community, is that in our difficult days, someone comes to our rescue. And it's our responsibility that in our good days to look out for someone that we can help. This has been a wonderful 30 days traveling. Andrea spent a few days with me. Colleen spent a few days. And then, of course, I finished up this campaign with Jeffrey on the road. I couldn't help but think how proud my father would be of the young man he's become. He doesn't have a bad sense of humor either when we're on the road. But you know what? We've only been able to do that because of your support. This is really your win tonight. I happen to be the one who has their name on the ballot. But all of you have surrounded us with a tremendous amount of support leading up to this campaign. You've allowed me to travel across this province to deliver our message, one of hope, one that is thoughtful, and one that is doable. I have made a commitment a long time ago that I was not going to allow public life to shape who I am. It's been my goal to try to shape public life. I will do my very best to respect and trust and make sure that as I travel this province, my actions reflect you, your views, your values, and the commitment of the people of Annapolis County. Tonight we celebrate, tomorrow we go to work. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here. Thank you for your tremendous support.